Hello students, my name is Mini Sethi. Today we are going to learn about Harrod-Domer growth model. Okay, Harrod-Domer growth model is given by Roy F. Harrod and F.C. Domer. Okay, this model is called classical Keynesian model of economical growth because this is based on Keynesian investment and saving analysis. That's why it's called classical Keynesian economic growth model. Okay, and Harrod and Domer basically define growth in term of saving and productivity of capital. Harrod and Domer both define growth in term of saving and productivity of capital. Firstly, we discuss what Harrod views about economical growth. Harrod basically talks about three type of growth: actual growth rate, warranted growth rate, and natural growth rate. Okay. Firstly, actual growth rate. What does mean by actual growth rate? We can get actual growth rate by simply divide change in income to total income. Okay. And formula of actual growth rate is delta y over y. Okay, delta y is change in income and y is total income. Okay, for example, our total income is 100 and change in income is 30, our 0.3 will our actual growth rate. Okay, and Harrod says that for getting stability in economic or for getting equilibrium situation in any economy, investment must be equal to saving. Okay, for getting investment equal to saving, we need to study about this equation. Okay, this equation is G multiplied by C equal to S. Okay, in this equation, G is our actual growth rate. G is our actual growth rate. C is our capital output ratio, which we can write as delta K over delta Y. Okay, and S is our saving income ratio, which we can write S over Y. Okay, now we put all determinant value in this equation. Firstly, we put value of G. This is delta Y over Y. Now we put value of C. This is delta K over delta Y. Now we put the value of S over Y. Okay, now this delta Y and this delta Y will cut each other, as we all know, and we will replace delta K equal to I, because delta K is equal to investment. So we will write I in place of delta K. Okay, as we replaced I in place of delta K, now this y will cut each other. Now two determinant is remaining, that is I and S. Okay, we can see that I is equal to investment, means investment is equal to saving, or we can say that saving is equal to investment. As Harrod say that for getting equilibrium in any economy, investment must be equal to saving. Okay, this is all about actual growth rate. Now we talk about warranted growth rate. What does mean by warranted growth rate? Warranted growth rate means when economy is working on their fuller capacity, all resources are utilizing full at their fuller capacity. For example, as income is increasing, obviously we are rising capital. We are buying tools, machinery, equipments, and all these resources are working on their fuller capacity. When all resources are working on their fuller capacity, it's called warranted growth rate. Okay. And this equation defined, in this equation, GW is your warranted growth rate, and multiply by CR. CR is your required capital, and S represent your saving income ratio. Okay, this equation represent GW is warranted growth rate, and CR is required capital, and S is your saving income ratio. Okay, now we talk about natural growth rate. What does mean by natural growth rate? Natural growth rate determined by natural factor, as your labor force or your technical progress. Okay, natural growth rate is determined by natural factor, such as your labor force or your technical progress. Okay, and this growth rate is required to maintain full employment. Or keep in your mind, this growth rate is necessary to maintain full employment in economy. Okay, now Harrod and Domer say that for stability in economy, all three growth rate must be equal to each other. But most of the time, these growth rate are not equal to each other. Okay, it will create instability in economy. What are these instability? First is deflation, second is inflation. Okay, in this diagram you can see that GW, is your warranted growth rate, and GN is your natural growth rate, and G is your actual growth rate. In this diagram, you can see that your warranted growth rate is more than your natural growth rate and your actual growth rate. In this diagram, your warranted growth rate is more than your natural growth rate and your actual growth rate. Okay, and your actual growth rate, this blue line is your actual growth rate line, and your actual growth rate represent your income. Okay, and this green line is warranted growth rate, and your warranted growth rate represent your output. In this diagram, you can see that your warranted growth rate is more than your actual growth rate, means your output is more than your income. Okay, if income is less, means demand is less. If output is more, means supply is more. If your demand is less than your supply, what happen? Price will reduce. If price will continue reduce, it will create situation of instability, that's called deflation. Okay, on the other hand, in this diagram you can see that your warranted growth rate is less than from your natural growth rate and your actual growth rate. You see, GW represent your warranted growth rate, G is your actual growth rate, G and your natural growth rate. In this diagram, you can see that your warranted growth rate is less than from your actual growth rate and natural growth rate. Okay, and your red line, this red line represent your actual growth rate, and your actual growth rate represent your growth in income. Okay, and your warranted growth rate represent your growth in output. Here you can see that your income is more than your output. If income is more, means demand is more. Output is less, means supply is less. In this case, your demand is more than supply. It can be cause of rise in supply. If rise in price, if price will continue rise, it will create the situation of inflation. This is view of economic growth, of this is Harrod view of economic growth. Now we discuss Domer views. Okay, Domer gave more important to investment. According to Domer, investment basically have two function: generation of income and increase in productivity. Generation of income is demand side effect, because when investment increase income, it will automatically increase demand. So a generation of income is demand side effect. On the other hand, increase in productivity is supply side effect, because when productivity increase, obviously there is increase in production of goods and service. So this is supply side effect. Okay, and equation of YD is I over alpha. Okay, here YD is level of effective demand. Okay, this is demand side equation. I will write here, this is demand side equation. In this equation, YD represent level of effective demand, and I represent level of net investment, and alpha represent MPS, marginal propensity to save. Okay, now supply side equation is YS equal to sigma multiply by K. Okay, and YS represent to level of output. YS represent level of output, and sigma represent capital output ratio, and K represent real capital. Okay, according to Domer, for getting steady growth, YD must be equal to S, means demand side must be equal to supply side. Okay, now we understand Domer model with the help of this diagram. In x-axis we take income, in y-axis we take saving and investment. At initially, economy is in equilibrium at S level. At beginning, we are in stability, or equilibrium is S1. Okay, in this equilibrium point, income is OY1 and saving is S1Y1, and investment is L1, that is equal to saving. Okay, in at beginning, economy in S1 level of equilibrium. Okay, in this level, income is OY1 and our saving is S1Y1 and our investment is L1, that is equal to saving. This investment create income equal to OY2. Because of this investment, our income is increased, that is equal to OY2. And in at this income, our saving level is S2Y2 and our investment is L2, that is equal to saving. This investment level again generate income in economy. Now income level is OY3 and saving is S3Y3 and investment is L3. Okay, this is all about Domer model. I think you understand whole Harrod and Domer model. Thank you.